Good evening, brothers and sisters. I'm Father Natalius from Holy Family Paris. As we know, today we enter the second Sunday of Lent. And the Word of God today reminds us to surrender ourselves totally to God in all situations of our lives. The story of Abraham leaving his homeland is shown in the first reading. This story shows us that Abraham totally surrendered his life to God. He was willing to leave his native land to go to the place promised by God. The purpose of his action was not because of discomfort or difficult situation in his hometown, but to fulfill God's mission, that is to build a great nation for Yahweh, a nation that believes in God. The point is, this action is not to achieve personal benefit and comfort, but to create a great nation who believes in God. Similarly, in the Gospel today, Jesus reminds Peter that his mission is to death on the cross, not to enjoy the glory on the top of mountain, the transfiguration that was seen by Peter and two other disciples made them to forget the important mission that was being carried out by Jesus. Peter only thought about the wonderful time that he has and want to stay on the top of the mountain with Jesus, Moses, and Elijah. But on the contrary, the climax of Jesus' glory is not in this transfiguration, but rather in the total surrender of his life by giving his life hanging on the cross. If we look at the Gospel of Matthew, the transfiguration took place before Jesus entered Jerusalem, or before he surrendered himself to those who want to crucify him. When we compare this transfiguration with the moment when Jesus hanging on the cross, we can see a clear picture of the reality of life. In the transfiguration, Jesus' clothes turn become white as a light, and he spoke with two great figures of the Old Testament, Moses and Elijah. But when hanging on the cross, he hung without clothes and spoke with two criminals. In the transfiguration, Peter and two other disciples felt happy and want to stay on the top of mountain with Jesus. But when he hung on the cross, no one wants to accompany him except Mary and his beloved disciples. Brothers and sisters, life is not always giving us happiness. Sometimes we need to accept the cross and the suffering. And sometimes, in a situation full of sorrow and suffering, we do not have anyone who help us, who accompany us. And then we think that we need to carry on the suffering alone. In this situation, it is easy for us to give up and feel hopeless. But God never left us alone. Like Mother Mary, who is always accompanying Jesus, so does our God always come and help us. Brothers and sisters, in this Lenten season, let us we give ourselves totally to God and also to others. especially those who experience many problems and difficulties. Hopefully, our presence can be a grace for others, particularly for those who are despair and loss of hope. We are one in God. Now, let us together, we pray for our families, for our relatives, and our friends, and also for all those who have died because of the coronavirus. May they have eternal life, and may God also help us to cooperate to overcome the problem. Let us also pray for our Pope Francis. May God give him good health. And now, let us together, we pray the prayer that Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We pray also, we ask Mother Mary to help us, to guide us, to accompany us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless us and also our family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good night, and God bless.